gentlemen, would you please make welcome, celebrating his 40th anniversary at the Grand Ole Opry, and soon to be the newest member of the Country Music Hall of Fame.
Good evening and howdy. Oh, I don't have to tell this much to say howdy but one time. Thank you so much for coming to Nashville to celebrate a wild weekend with us. Does anybody here like country music? What a dumb question. I got the alarm clock set for 7. I got the taxi call for 9. At 11, and I gotta be there on time. Told the boss I was going to my mother's. Told mama I was gonna see a friend. I don't want no one to know I'm slipping out of town on a wild weekend. I'm gonna have a wild weekend. I'm gonna have a wild weekend. With a pretty little blonde-haired, blue-eyed darling, I'm gonna have a wild weekend. Well, we might go up to the mountains, we might go down to the sea, somewhere off from the big wide world, just my baby and me. Baby's gonna cook me breakfast. Baby's gonna tuck me in. Baby's gonna warm my cold, cold lips with kisses for the wild weekend. I'm gonna have a wild weekend. I'm gonna have a wild weekend. With a pretty little blonde-haired, blue-eyed darling, I'm gonna be a wild weekend. Yes, we'll talk about the future. We'll make a lot of plans and stuff. Mostly though, we're just gonna sit by the fire and make a lot of love. Every man ought to try it at least one time in his life. Just get away on a wild weekend, like I'm gonna do with my wife. I'm gonna have a wild weekend. I'm gonna have a wild weekend. With the pretty little mother of my 3 children, I'm gonna have a wild weekend. Oh, ain't that what we're having in Nashville, Tennessee? In Dixon, Tennessee, this weekend. I'm so honored that you folks came from all over the world, literally. We got folks here from the other side of the Atlantic Ocean, from Scotland. We got folks from the Bahamas. We got folks came all the way from Alabama. We got them from everywhere. And boy, this has been some week for me. This has been a roller coaster, I'm telling you. Monday afternoon, they called me and told me they were going to put me in the Hall of Fame. And I tell you what, I was just there. Woo! Then I picked up the paper this morning, read where they canceled my TV show. They don't have much respect for people in the Hall of Fame, do they? Well, hey, it'll all work out. It'll all come out in the wash. And besides that, if they cancel the show, I can always go back to singing the first song I sang at the Grand Ole Opry. It was the story of my life back then, and it's probably getting ready to be again. It's called We Ain't Nothing But Poor Folks. there's a whole lot of people looking down their noses at me. 'Cause I didn't come from a wealthy family. There was 10 of us living in a two-room shack on the banks of the river by the railroad track. We kept chickens in a pen in the bank, and everybody said we was poor folks. My daddy was a farmer, but all he ever raised was us. He dug a 40-foot well and hit 36 gallons of dust. The Salvation Army gave us clothes to wear. A man from the county came to cut our hair. We lived next door to a millionaire, but we wanted nothing except poor folks. We was poor folks living in a rich folks' world. We sure was a hungry bunch. If a wolf had ever come to our front door, he'd have had to brought a picnic lunch. My granddaddy's pension was $1.33. That was $10 less than the landlord wanted for rent. The landlord's letters got nasty indeed. He wrote, "Get out," but Paul couldn't read. And we was too broke to even pay heed. But that's how it is when you're poor folks. A picnic lunch, but we had something in our house money can't buy. Kept us warm in the winter, cool when the sun was high. But whenever we didn't have food enough, and the howling winds would get pretty rough, we'd patch the cracks, and we set the table with love. 'Cause that's what you do when you're poor folks. And we want nothing but poor folks. My mama and my daddy was poor folks. My brother and my sister was poor folks. My dog and my cat was poor folks. And if you bought gasoline this week, you're poor folks. Just made that last part up. Of course, actually, as we're doing this, gasoline prices are going down. Let's hope they keep right on going down. Most of you probably know why I picked up my guitar in the middle of that song. But since we're filming this for a home video and stuff, we need to let all the folks that are watching know that I play the guitar on 3 or 4 songs on every show, because I have an endorsement arrangement with the people that furnished me my guitar. See, a lot of the big stars endorse certain brands of guitars. The great Chet Atkins always either played a Gretsch guitar or a Gibson guitar. My buddy Steve Warner always plays a Takamine guitar. And Garth Brooks and Vince Gill play the Taylor guitars. And so I stop on every show and thank the nice folks that furnished my guitar, and I kind of endorse it by playing it a little bit. Most of you know the folks that gave me this guitar put a little plaque on the back of it, and I'm so proud of it. It says, "To Bill Anderson, from all of your friends at Walmart."
They were on the ledge. I tried.
tried all day to write. Just a little while ago, I saw them falling on your picture as I kissed it goodnight. I love you.
So nice. Thank you very, very much. Well, I know that you folks here in the auditorium know without me telling you that we've been hanging our hat at a little place called the WSM Grand Ole Opry for 40 years this weekend. Whew. Boy, it seems like yesterday. It really does. I don't know where the 40 years have gone, but... They tell me I joined the Grand Ole Opry on the 15th day of July back in 1961. I was 4 years old. Okay, I was 5 years old. I was a little boy. Oh, my goodness, the memories. 40 years. Do you have any idea how many wonderful memories are stored up in this old brain of mine? I have had more fun than anybody ought to ever be allowed to have in one lifetime. And I've stood on that stage and I've laughed. And I've stood on that stage and I've cried. And I've stood on that stage with friends of mine that are lifelong friends. And I've stood on that stage and said goodbye to some wonderful people. I've stood on that stage and welcomed new people into the Grand Ole Opry family. And I sat out in the audience just recently and served as a pallbearer at one of my closest friends' funerals that I'd shared that stage with many times. But the number one memory that I'll always have, if I'm at the Opry for 40 more years, there will never be a memory like the memory of sharing that stage with Mr. Roy Acuff on the times that we got together and performed. There was no magic like watching Roy Acuff weave his magic over a crowd at the Grand Ole Opry. I would go out on the stage and sing the first part of this song, and when it came time for Mr. Roy to come in, I would turn to my right. I never did it without being nervous, and I'd watch Mr. Roy come walking into that spotlight, his white silver hair shining in the night. And he'd wrap his fingers around that microphone, and he would sing with more feeling than most people could even imagine. Turning back the clock tonight and dedicating this song to the memory of Mr. Roy and Cousin Minnie and Mr. Bill Monroe and Ernest Tubb and Red Foley and Marty Robbins, and the list goes on and on and on. And with the bass player in our band filling some pretty big shoes and singing Roy Acuff's part for you, I want to do the most special song I've ever done at the Opry, called I Wonder If God Likes Country Music. One night we were out on tour, getting ready to do a show. And you know, at the time, it really wasn't anything special. It was
what you might call just another one-night stand. When I looked over my guitar, and there stood an old man. His cowboy clothes were frayed and worn, and his boots were far from new. He said, I'd like to sit in with your band. You see, I'm a country singer too. Well, we just all had a big laugh. And when I looked back at the old man, there was a tear in his eye. I told the band to cool it, 'cause I didn't want to see him cry. He reached down and he took my guitar with a determined look on his face. But then as he started to play and sing, a look of sadness took its place. He said, I've sang my songs from Maine to California, seen the world through the window of a car. I never saved a dime back when I made it. I always thought someday I'd be a star. But now my voice is cracked and no one wants me. My wife gave up on me years ago. It's been so long, my kids don't even know me. And picking and singing is the only life I know. And then he said,
I wonder if God likes country music. Will there be a place up there to sing my song? Will he make my fingers nimble like they used to be, so I can play the chords and sing along? I wonder if God likes country music.
I just stood there. None of us really knew what to say. He took my old guitar and he put it down ever so gently. And then as he turned to leave, the band stood up and applauded. And I can still hear his words today.
I wonder if God likes country music. To sing my song. Will he make my fingers nimble like they used to be, so I can play the chords and sing along?
Try. Look yonder coming. coming down the railroad track. It's the orange blossom special, bringing my baby back.
Oh, bring her back now.
Did you notice that's a girl? Oh, in case you haven't noticed, two of the boys in my band are girls. I'll introduce them all to you as we go along tonight. Special songs, special memories, looking back over 40 years at the Grand Ole Opry. To some of you, this is a new song, because in 1992 it was a number one hit by a young man named Steve Warner. For some of you that remember back a little before that, you might remember in the 1970s it was a hit for Gene Shepherd. In 1966, it was a hit for the great Eddie Arnold. In 1963, it was a hit for my buddy Roy Clark.
But the original record of this song came out in 1960, a year before I even joined the Grand Ole Opry. The original version of the song went something like this. I reached out my arms and I touched you with soft words. I whispered your name.
I held your love on the tips of my fingers,
but that was as close as I came. My eyes had a vision of sweet lips yielding beneath my command.
I held your love on the tips of my fingers,
but I slip right through my hands. Yes, I let you slip right through my hands.
Somebody took you when I wasn't looking, and I should have known from the start.
The love hidden deep in your heart. To the love hidden deep in your heart. My fingers.
Thank you. And going back almost as far as that one is this one.
Live a life of lies and fantasy, then face the truth and realize you're with me. You built me up so high, my heart can't stand the fall, and life without your love just isn't life at all. So walk out backwards if you must go, and please don't wave goodbye, just wave one last hello. The truth won't hurt so much if I can just pretend. So walk out backwards and I'll think you're walking in. that day down to this, you walked all over me. And now you're walking out to love somebody new. Oh, but you're not by yourself, 'cause my heart's leaving too. So walk out backwards if you must go. And please don't wave goodbye, just wave one last hello. The truth won't hurt so much if I can just pretend. So walk out backwards and I'll think you're walking in. Just walk out backwards and I'll think you're walking in.
Is that country enough? You know what I love? I love seeing these posters that people hang on the wall and these little books where they make fun of country music song titles. Every time you see one of those books, every time you see one of those posters, it's got a bunch of real... See, it's people that don't understand country music. They don't understand a song called Walk Out Backwards and I'll Think You're Walking In. I bet they wouldn't have no idea what to do with I Hope You're Living As High on the Hog as the Pig You Turned Out to Be. Oh, and the one I was always gonna write called The Only Good Years We Had Were the Tires on Our Car. I got a friend of mine, the true story, friend of mine here in Nashville, I won't call his name, he's a very well-known songwriter, told me the other day that he wrote a song called I've Been Married 40 Years and It Only Took Me 7 Wives. See, in country music, old boy sitting over saying, yeah, I know what he means. Now, see, country music, we don't beat around the bush, see? You listen to these songs they write on Tin Pan Alley. Moon, June, and Spoon. I wrote one the other day called If She Don't Light Your Fire, Buddy, Your Wood's Wet. True, I did. That's as far as I'm going with that. I'm going to stop right there. But see, I mean, I try to keep an open mind. I really do. I love all kind. Go ahead. I'll wait. I'm in no hurry. I got all night. I try to keep an open mind about music because I love all. I really do. There's some good music in every field of music. I've always told people there's two kinds of music. There's good and there's bad. And I've made some of both over the years. I'm partial to country music. Of course I am. I grew up listening to country music. I've loved country music all of my life. And it bothers me sometimes when I sit down and try to write a country song and pour out my emotions and my feelings, and I try to write the emotions and the feelings of people I know. And people come up to me and say, oh, that's good, that's good. But it's too country. Two words that don't belong in the same sentence, folks. Too country. What's that? Is it like too Republican or too Democrat? Is it too far to the left? Too far to the right? Too straight down the middle? Is it too black or too white? Are the biscuits too fluffy? Is the chicken too fried? Is the gravy too thin?
Are the peas too black-eyed? Is the iced tea too sweet? Does it have too much tang? Are there too many lemons in Mama's lemon meringue? Are the roses too red? Is the sunshine too bright? Are there too many stars in the heavens at night? Are there too many fish that still jump in the stream? Is the blue sky too blue? Is the clean air too clean? Is it too many pearls of wisdom under Grandpa's old hat? Is it just too old-fashioned? Is it just too antique? Is the question too strong? Is the answer too weak? Is the grace too amazing? Is the steeple too tall? Are there too many yes sirs, yes ma'ams, and how are y'all? Is the message too real, too close to the bone? Do the fiddle and steel remind you too much of home? Is honest and true just not in demand? I don't understand. Thank you very much. I guess that song just kind of stands on its own. In case you don't know, I do want to tell you that my buddy, the young, talented guy, Brad Paisley, has just recorded that song in his new album. And Brad couldn't find any real backup singers, so he asked me and George Jones and Buck Owens to sing on it with him. And I'm pretty proud of that. I only hope that one day, somewhere at the Grand Ole Opry, at the Crystal Palace in Bakersfield, California, where Buck lives, somewhere, I just pray that the four of us can get together on stage one time and do that song live. That'll be the thrill of a lifetime. Speaking of talented people, how about these six ladies and gentlemen that are playing the music up here on the stage tonight, huh? See, I told you get some new shirts, they'd clap loud for you. Real quick, most of you know them, but one more time, you can let them know how much you appreciate them. They all live in Nashville, and as I tell people everywhere, they come from different parts of America. Our keyboard player, who plays not only the keyboards, but does all our vocal arrangements from Gate City, Virginia, Mr. Ziggy Johnson, ladies and gentlemen. On the red bass guitar. Down, sir. You're going to have to either dye that shirt or that guitar. They don't quite match each other, but what a great job on the Roy Acuff part of I Wonder If God Likes Country Music. From Lawrenceburg, Tennessee, Mr. James Gordon Fries, ladies and gentlemen. And wearing out the fiddle on the Orange Blossom Special and any other song that she plays. From Yorkville, Illinois, Miss Gail Rudisell.
The drummer doesn't know this. He's from Texas. No, he knows that. He knows where he's from. What he doesn't know is in the lobby of the Opryland Hotel night before last, I ran into some people from your hometown, from Poteet, Texas, and they said that they knew you, and you weren't worth a dime when you were down there. No, I'm only kidding. From Poteet, Texas, Mr. Cotton Payne on the drums. Get up there, Cotton. From over in Oak Ridge, Tennessee, a wonderful steel guitar player. I told you there were two boys in the band that was girls. Gail's one of them, and this is the other one. Miss Donna Hammett, ladies and gentlemen, our great steel guitar player. Well, that only leaves me and Grandpa. Did y'all see that little grandbaby out there tonight, huh? He's a good-looking thing. You had blood tests run? Looks like his daddy. No, he looks like his daddy. He looks like his mama. Looks better than his grandpa. Isn't that wonderful? Being a grandpa for the first time. That's pretty special. I know, believe me. All right, now let me put this all in perspective. I'm celebrating my 40th anniversary on the Opry. He's played with me for 20 years. He's been there half of the time. His daddy sent me an email today, and I appreciated that. He said, congratulations on 40 years. I hope you'll be there for 40 more, and please keep Les with you. I don't know if that meant I hope you keep him employed or don't let him come home, but it meant one or the other. From Cropsey, Illinois, the leader of our band and my right hand, Mr. Les Singer, ladies and gentlemen on the guitar. This lady right down here on the front row. Man, let me tell you, 40 years at the Opry, and how many years now you've been president of my fan club? 14 years. She's the best fan club president in the world, Miss Jean Brown, ladies and gentlemen. Jean worked so hard to organize this event. Bless her heart, she's been in Nashville three times in the last 4 or 5 weeks. She was here for fanfare. Well, and then, not in Nashville, but then she came to Commerce for our big City Lights Festival in Commerce, Georgia, and then back here for the 40th anniversary celebration. Ain't you getting tired of looking at me? I ain't getting tired of looking at you. You're going to be here what?
In October.
In October? What's happening in October? Oh, that October. Oh, okay. Thank you. You know, I do some things that even Gene doesn't know about. All right, get your minds out of the gutter now. I go places and do things that I don't tell people about. That don't sound right either, does it? This ain't coming out right. I'm gonna try one more time. Last July, I won't go into all the details, but a year ago this month, I got a phone call from a man in Des Moines, Iowa, who told me that his father had raised him on my music, that they used to sit and watch my television show on Channel 5 out of Ames, Iowa, when he was growing up. And he said his father was a big, big country music fan. And his father was living in Sun City, Arizona, just outside of Phoenix. And he was terminally ill, and he was about to die with cancer. And this gentleman in Iowa said to me, he said, what would it take for you to go to Phoenix, Arizona, and sing for my daddy? I said, well, a plane ticket would help. He said, if I sent you a plane ticket, would you go out there? I said, no, but if you send me two plane tickets, I'll go, because I ain't going to go without less. So, two plane tickets came in the mail to go to Phoenix, Arizona on a Sunday morning in July. And Les and I flew out there, worked the Opry that night, got up at the crack of dawn. We flew to Phoenix. They met us and took us to a little motel to clean up, and then they came and picked us up in a car and took us out to Sun City, which is, how many miles? I'm looking for Phyllis. How many miles is that? Several. There you are. How many miles? That's outside. It's west of Phoenix, right? Several. It took us about an hour. We were in Tempe. It took us about an hour or so to get out to this house. They had not told this gentleman that we were coming. His wife knew and his son knew, but he didn't know. And when the car pulled up, they were looking out the window and they saw us coming up, and the young man and his mother met us at the door and thanked us for coming. We went in this living room, and his father was sitting there in his robe and his pajamas watching a golf tournament on television. He didn't know we were within 1,100 miles of there. And we walked in the room, and his wife said, honey, look who's here. And he looked up at me and he said, well, I'll be darned, I seen you on TV last night. I said, yep, that was me. He said, what are you doing here? I said, well, I got my guitar and I got my guitar picker. We just came to sing some songs. You want to sing some songs with us? I don't think he believed it for a minute. He turned the volume down on the TV and he kind of sat there and he kind of looked at us with a puzzled look on his face. And Les got out his guitar and got out my guitar, and Les tuned both of them because I don't tune them too well. And I said, what would you like to hear? I was a little nervous. I didn't quite know how this was all going to work out. And he said, he said, you probably don't know the old country songs. He said, I like the old country songs. I said, what's your very favorite song? He said, you don't know it. I said, what is it? He said, it's called The Wreck of the Old 97. I said, oh, you mean this one? They gave him his orders in Monroe, Virginia, saying, Steve, you're way behind time. This is not 38, but it's old 97. Just put her in dispenser on time. And then he looked around and said to his black, greasy fireman, just shovel on a little more coal. And when we cross that white old mountain, you can watch old 97 roll. Mighty rough road from Lynchburg to Danville in a line on a 3-mile grade. It was on that grade he lost his air brakes. You see what a jump he made. He was going down the grade, making 90 miles an hour, when his whistle broke into a scream. He was found in the wreck with his hand on the throttle and scalded to death by the steam. And then my favorite verse, listen, ladies. Now, ladies, you must take a warning from this time on and learn. Never speak harsh words to your true loving husband. He may leave you and never return. He may leave you and never return.
Whoa. We'll fix it in a bit.
Ha 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 ha!
I said, is that the song you meant? He didn't believe I knew that song. Well, I didn't know it all that good, but we faked it sitting there in his living room. I said, who's your favorite singer? He said, my all-time favorite singer was Hank Williams. I said, that's funny, so was mine. I said, what's your favorite Hank Williams song? He said, not one of his most popular songs. He said, you probably don't know this one either. I said, which one? He said, it's an old song called May You Never Be Alone Like Me. And I said, I bet I do.
Like a bird that's lost its mate in flight, I'm alone and oh so blue tonight. Like a piece of driftwood on the sea, may you never be alone like me. I gave up my friends, I left my home. When you promised you'd be mine alone, now you're gone, our love can never be. May I believe the lies you told to me when you whispered, dear, I worship thee. Now here am I, alone and blue, all because I love no one but you. The Bible, God's own word to say, for every wrong, someday you'll pay. I pray the Lord will set me free. May you
He plays good for an old grandpa. The son had asked us when we went to Phoenix, I said, how long do you want us to play? What do you want us to do? He said, oh, if y'all would just play about 45 minutes, that'd be fine. And said, Mom will fix some sandwiches, and we'll eat a little bit, and we'll take y'all back to the hotel. We'll come get you and take you to the airport in the morning. Well, about 4 hours later, we quit. And then we ate the sandwiches, and then we picked some more. What time did we? It was after dark when we left. It really was. But it was, I want to tell you something, that was one of the most, I don't know how to say it, inspiring maybe. I don't know if that's the right word. It was one of the most special moments that I think I have ever had in my whole career. An audience of one, plus his wife and his son. But I realized that the son told me as I walked out, he said, that's the happiest I've seen him in about 2 years. He was grinning from ear to ear. And I thought, and I realized the power that music has, the power that music has to touch people, and the power that it has to the healing power of music. Because for one afternoon on a Sunday in July last year, we made a man out in Arizona real, real happy. Just because we sang some songs. Unfortunately, I got a letter from his wife in September, and he'd passed away. But it was a wonderful day and a wonderful memory, and I wanted to share that with y'all tonight. I'd have spent a lot more time out in the pouring rain without an umbrella, covering my head. And I'd have stood up to that bully when he pushed and shoved and called me names. But I was too afraid. And I'd have gone on and seen Elvis that night he came to town. And Mama said I couldn't. And I'd have gone skinny dipping with Jenny Carson that time she dared me to, but I didn't. Oh, I'd have done a lot of things different. I wish I'd have spent more time with my dad when he was alive. Now I don't have the chance. And I wish I'd have told my brother just how much I loved him before he went off to war. But I just shook his hand. And I wish I'd have gone to church on Sunday mornings when my grandma begged me to. But I was scared of God. And I wish I would listen when they said, boy, you're gonna wish you had, but I wouldn't. Oh, I'd have done a lot of things different. People say they wouldn't change a thing, even if they could. Oh, but I would. Was this red dress she wanted one time so bad she could taste it. I should have bought it, but I didn't. And she wanted to paint our bedroom yellow and trim it in blues and greens, but I wouldn't let her. It wouldn't hurt nothing. Oh, and she loved to be held and kissed and touched, but I didn't do it. Not nearly enough. And if I'd have known that dance was gonna be our last dance, I'd have told the band to play on and on and on and on and on. I'd have done a lot of things.
much different. People say they wouldn't change a thing, even if they could. Oh, but I would. Yes, I'd have done a lot of things different. Oh, I'd have done a lot of things different.
Of two arms around her, but it didn't take her long to learn. You had new worlds to conquer, so you didn't want her or anything cramping your style. But don't she look great in the new dress I bought her? And don't she look good when she smiles? Did you really think you were so all important? She couldn't get by on her own. Did you really think losing you would destroy her? And that's why she kept hanging on. She stuck to her promise and talked to her conscience. She did all she could for a while. Then she picked up the pieces and she started living. Now don't she look good when she smiles? Don't she look good in the new dress I bought her and the new way that she wears her hair? She is in a new world and she's not the same girl. She knows now that somebody cares. You can't believe that the same girl you let go could change so in this little while. But don't she look great in the new dress I bought? And don't she look good when she smiles? Don't she look good in the new dress I bought her and the new way that she wears her hair? She is in a new world and she's not the same girl. She knows now that somebody cares. You can't believe that the same girl you let go could change so in this little while. Oh, but don't she look great in the new dress I bought her, and don't she look good when she smiles? Oh, don't she look great in the new dress I bought her, and don't she look good when she smiles?
Far apart.
After all this time, you're still on my mind. I've lost count of the hours, and I've lost track of the days. In fact, I've lost just about everything since you went away. Everything that is, except the memories you left me. And that's one thing that no one can mar. I don't know who you're with. I don't even know where you've gone. My only hope is that someday you might hear this song, and you'll know that I wrote it especially for you. And I love you wherever you are. Still, after all this time, still, you're still on my mind. This old flame in my heart is like an eternal fire. For every day it burns hotter, and every day it burns higher. And I haven't been able to put out one little flicker, not even with all of these tears. My friends all think I'm crazy. Maybe I am. But I'll carry this torch just as long as I can. For someday you might just decide to come home, and I want you to know I'm still here.
Still,
though you broke my heart,
still,
though we're far apart,
gentlemen, Bill Anderson.
You didn't think you was going to get rid of us that easy, did you? Thank you. Thank you very much.
Since way back when, sometimes I don't ever want this music to end. I want you to know, after all these years, you're still the one I want to whisper in your ear. You're still the one that makes me laugh, still the one that's my better half. We're still having fun, and you're still the one. Well, you're still the one, still the one. We're still having fun, and you're still the one. You are still the one that makes me strong, still the one I want to take along. We're still having fun, and all of you folks here tonight, you're still the one.
Thank y'all so much for coming down to Dixon to be with us. We've had a wonderful time. We'll see you in the morning at the Springhouse Golf Course. We'll have a wonderful time together. We'll have lunch together. And tomorrow night, we'll go to the Grand Ole Opry together. Thank you so much. Good night. God bless you. Drive careful.
Ladies and gentlemen,